BrahMos, the jointly developed Indo-Russian supersonic cruise missile, is all set to be one of the first of its kind to be integrated on a fighter aircraft for the Indian Air Force. The Indian Ministry of Defense, MOD, stated the Indian Air Force, IAF, successfully test-fired the air-launched BrahMos A supersonic cruise missile from a Sukhoi Su-30MKI fighter on May 22nd. The MOD noted in a statement, "The launch from the aircraft was smooth and the missile followed the desired trajectory before directly hitting the land target." As per reports, this test firing was part of the BrahMos missile's certification trials, which has two validations, one against a naval and another against a ground target. The second test is expected to be conducted soon, though exact details are not available. After that test, BrahMos is expected to be declared operational and formally inducted into the IAF. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes India test firing of BrahMos from Su-30MKI. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. In September 2010, India's newly constituted Tri-Services Strategic Forces Command, SFC, submitted a proposal to the Defense Ministry for setting up two dedicated squadrons of aircraft comprising 42 Su-30MKI air dominance fighters. Viewers may note that Su-30MKI is a customized variant of Su-30. The main objective of this mini air force is to deliver nuclear weapons. The picture became clearer in October of 2012 when the Cabinet Committee on Security greenlighted a program to carry out structural and software modifications on 42 Su-30MKI and acquire 216 air-launched BrahMos missiles. Until then, the BrahMos was for exclusive use by the Navy. In March 2015, the SFC received the first of these 42 Sukhois, which will be modified to equip the air-launched version of the supersonic BrahMos. This is the first time that the SFC, which at present depends on the Indian Air Force for delivering nuclear weapons under its command, is acquiring its own aerial assets. Apart from delivery of nukes, BrahMos integration with a fighter jet will also pave the way to make it more flexible conventional tactical weapon for precision strike, as it will become a multi-platform weapon. Individually, the Su-30MKI and BrahMos are powerful weapons. But when one of the world's most capable 4-plus generation fighter is armed with a uniquely destructive cruise missile, together they are a dramatic force multiplier. When the Indo-Russian BrahMos is deployed on the Su-30MKI, Indian Air Force pilots would no longer have to fly deep into heavily defended airspace to strike enemy targets. Instead, they can launch a BrahMos from far away and turn back to safety while the missile flies on to do the destruction. This will create a unique challenge for Pakistan and China. BrahMos is developed jointly by India's Defense Research and Development Organization and Russia's NPO Mashinostroyenie. It's powered by a ramjet engine. BrahMos is currently considered to be one of the most deadly cruise missiles. The reason is its unique features. 1. It has a supersonic speed of Mach 3, or 1 kilometer per second, providing very little time to intercept. 2. BrahMos uses a 300 kilogram, or 660 pounds, semi-armor-piercing warhead, and also has very high kinetic energy, since kinetic energy is directly proportional to the square of velocity. BrahMos actually has about 9 times the kinetic energy of conventional subsonic missile like Tomahawk. The combined destructive force of massive warhead and kinetic energy is lethal even for the biggest surface warships and bunkers. BrahMos has been known to break ships in half in several tests. 3. It can perform S maneuvers in the final stages of flight. The missile basically doesn't move in a straight line, making it very hard to intercept. 4. There are lots of redundancies in the guidance system, right from the INS, GPS, GLONASS, and Gagan, making it hard to jam. 5. The accuracy of around 1 square meter makes it apt for a precision strike on high-value targets. Sukhoi in Russia and HAL in India independently conducted feasibility studies. This resulted in a new variant of BrahMos. BrahMos A, Air, is a modified variant of its basic configuration and specifically designed for air launch. It features several design refinements, which include a lighter propulsion system, weight reduction to 5,500 pounds or 2,500 kilograms from 6,600 pounds or 3,000 kilograms, as well as redesigned fins and nose cap. After the Indian Air Force determined that HAL had evolved the simpler, most manageable design, it placed an order to HAL in January 2014 to integrate the BrahMos onto the Su-30MKI. Though BrahMos A is lighter than original BrahMos, it's still a heavy missile, and integration with a fighter aircraft was met with many technical challenges, some of which are listed as follows. 1. A key task was to strengthen the Su-30MKI airframe, particularly its underbelly weapon station. New hardpoints and structural modifications were required. 2. Since the BrahMos protrudes beyond the Su-30MKI air intakes, it was imperative to ascertain that it did not impede the flow of air into the fighter's engines. This was achieved through the computational fluid dynamics modeling. 3. New cockpit controls had to be added for pilots so they can use it while launching the BrahMos. On June 25, 2016, a modified Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su-30MKI aircraft carried a BrahMos A. This is the first time in the world that such a heavyweight supersonic cruise missile was integrated on a fighter aircraft. The twin-seat multi-role fighter took off and conducted a 45-minute sortie with the missile attached to its underbelly. Sukhoi 30MKI has a range of 1,800 miles or 3,000 kilometers, which can be extended with mid-air refueling or using disposable fuel pods. India has entered into the Missile Technology Control Regime, MTCR, which effectively gives it a free hand in developing or importing long-range missiles from other countries. Before this, Russia could not help or jointly develop a missile with a non-MTCR nation like India, whose range is more than 300 kilometers. This is why BrahMos range had to be limited below 300 kilometers initially. India and Russia have decided to double the range of BrahMos missile from existing 185 miles, that's 300 kilometers, to 370 miles, or 600 kilometers. Russian President Putin has stated some time back, "We have agreed to improve the BrahMos missile, which will be land, air, and sea launched. We will also work to increase its range." As per most strategic experts, the range enhancement will require only minor changes in software and hardware. It's a widely accepted fact that BrahMos always had the ability of much greater range. It is that now it will be unlocked. Since the missile is very fast and is maneuverable, it will be almost impossible to intercept. Pakistan and China have no defense against BrahMos. A fact of the matter is that even the United States, with all its advanced technologies, will find this missile very hard to intercept. The massive range of the weapon combo will hugely bolster India's strike capabilities. BrahMos integration with Sukhoi 30MKI will certainly be a very serious challenge to both Pakistan and China, especially when the range of the BrahMos is extended to 370 miles, 600 kilometers.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.